This video will walk you through the steps to analyze your sushi DNA barcode sequence data. As described in the lab handout, you'll first be assessing the quality of the sequence itself and removing any ambiguous nucleotide assignments made by the algorithm. We'll use a free program called Mega to do this. I've provided a link to download the software in the lab handout and below, so if you haven't done so yet, now would be a good time. Our sequencing vendor has provided us with the raw chromatogram trace files, and this is what we'll be analyzing. Your instructor has provided these files to you on Canvas. So to start, download the .ab1 trace file corresponding to your sushi sample that you are analyzing and save it to your computer somewhere you can find it. Open up the Mega program, go to Align, then Edit, View, Sequencing Files, Trace, and find the AB1 file you saved to your computer. This should open up the trace file in a new Trace Editor window like you see here. You can resize the window and use the slider up here to change the zoom and wave height of the electropherogram so it's easier to view. You'll notice that each nucleotide call is associated with a different color. T's are red, C's are blue, G's are black, and A's are green. Notice also that here at the beginning and at the end of the sequence, and possibly scattered here and there throughout, depending on the quality of the sequence data, there are N's. These represent uncalled nucleotides that didn't meet the quality threshold for the algorithm to make a confident nucleotide call. This is common at the ends of the sequence, very near to and far from the primer being used to sequence the DNA. We're going to trim the low quality sequence at either end and see if we can confidently assign nucleotides to any remaining ends in the sequence. Now in this sample, this N is the last ambiguous call at the beginning. So I'm going to use my cursor to highlight this N, then click the icon, mask upstream of the cursor. You can also access this from the edit menu. The upstream sequence should go gray to indicate it is now masked or ignored. I'm going to do the same for the end of the sequence, but choose mask downstream of the cursor. Now position your cursor immediately after the masked sequence at the beginning and highlight the first nucleotide of good sequence. Then click this N icon to jump to the next ambiguous call in the sequence. Examine the peaks and see if you can confidently assign a nucleotide, and if you can, change the N to the appropriate letter. If not, leave the N there. Now this sample is pretty good, so there aren't any other ambiguous calls, but your sequence might have some. Once you have reviewed the entire sequence and are happy with your editing, go to Data, Export FASTA File, and save the resulting file with a sensible name to your computer. Now you're ready to move on to the rest of the analysis.